YouTube rock star Vano explains Red is not a charity. Red is a brand name for a number of consumer items sold by big companies who give a slice of their profits from them to the Global Fund.
You know, what's great about Red is I'm not asking you to give money or write a check for charity. I'm asking you to buy Red products, and the companies who make those products will be writing a check to charity. That's so cool.
Gap makes Red-branded t-shirts. Tamsin Smith, president of Red, explains that Gap stores were the first to be involved in the Red venture.
Gap had been sourcing in sub-Saharan Africa for many years. They'd been instrumental in passing the trade bill that opened up sub-Saharan Africa to apparel trade. And not many consumers knew that. And so when they decided to join Red, they made a commitment to make as much of the product line in Africa as they possibly could.
Red chairman Bobby Schreiber, visiting a Gap factory in Lesotho, shows off how Red products are identified and how he hopes to build appeal for them.
I hope that the demand for this product and the other products they're going to make here, which we're going to brand with the Gap's help, this little symbol that you see here, this little symbol in red, that consumers around the world, when they see this, will want to buy it. And that mark will be on product made from this factory. So if demand for these things increases, we hope that more money will flow here to buy the drugs for the people.
Another company involved is Hallmark Greeting Cards. It is producing more than 200 types of cards for Product Red. Each card sold will buy a single dose of medicine to reduce the risk of HIV transmission from a mother to her baby during childbirth. Their red bags are made from mud cloth fabric from Mali. Red President Tamsin Smith believes using African products are an important part of the business model.
So for us, it completes the circle in a sense. Not only is medicine more readily available and testing more readily available, but there's an opportunity that someone working in a factory in Africa can actually be a part of creating an item that is generating the money that goes back into their communities.
Motorola makes a red phone. Apple makes a red iPod. Armani makes designer fashions and accessories. Converse Sneakers has put their footprint on the red movement, too. The first Converse product was a red shoe inspired by the use of mud cloth. Converse is collaborating with artists and pop culture icons to develop more than 40 designs. The company's website has the Make Mine Red option that helps consumers design their own shoes. And Red keeps growing. Microsoft and Dell are the latest and biggest new partners. Founder of Microsoft, Bill Gates, admits that he's pleasantly surprised by the success of Red.
People know that as part of their purchase, it's going to make a difference and save lives. So it's a great combination, you know, the best work of all of us brought together.
Michael Dell, chairman of the company that bears his name, is excited.
This is a way to actually save lives.
Since its launch last year, Red has made more than $100 million for the Global Fund. Currently, there are 3 HIV/AIDS grants supported by the fund in Ghana, Rwanda, and Swaziland. Those projects involve healthcare, preventive information, training, and drug therapy for thousands of people. Bano is hopeful the new Microsoft and Dell Red computers will help save more lives.
When you buy these computers with this system in it, all the money that goes to Red goes directly to Africans who will be dead were it not for those drugs that are keeping them alive.
Carolyn Turner, VOA News.